This is the YGTV News with Georgina White.
Welcome to the YGTV News. These are the main headlines today on Friday the 10th of February. I'm Georgina White. Judge rules against care agency in baby tea case. GABA wins match against Gosport ABC. Bus club card system to be scrapped. Minister for Environment reconvenes Climate Change Forum. FITAM to question government on future job strategy. And finally, Gerard Theuma to take over as CEO of GBC. The Supreme Court has ruled that a terminally eligible Tehran baby be withheld from invasive medical procedures that could delay his death. The baby, identified as Baby T in court, is only 10 months old and suffers from an extremely rare genetic disease called Wolff-Hishon syndrome. The condition causes severe medical complications, including severe cardiac and respiratory problems, and deafness and blindness. The court case saw Baby T's doctors ruling against the care agency and the baby's mother, who asked the court to order that everything possible be done to delay the child's death, on the basis that prolonging life outweighed any suffering that he might be subjected to in the process. The care agency and mother did not present any medical evidence to support the case. Last night saw the Gibraltar Amateur Boxing Association's big fight against Gosport ABC. The bouts proved extremely successful for Gibraltar, with 7 out of 8 wins. Youngest fighter Kevin Kennedy fought against Kieran Chapman and won on points. Tyron Buttigieg fought against Kyle Cockrum, with the match resulting in a no contest due to a low blow. Ryan Kennedy fought against Fergie Cortez and won on points. Axel Roca fought against John Fernandez and won on points. Paul Bohr fought against Dan Godem and won ref's top contest. Gustav Baksai fought against Mohamed Attar and won on points. Heavyweight Paul Bray fought against Robin Mikos and won on points. And finally, David Gajardo fought against James Bone and won ref's top contest. The bus company has stated that the new £5-a-year bus pass system is being reviewed by the new government and may not come into place. There has been a bit of a confusion here. The system was going to be put into place, but the new administration is reviewing it, although we already have the club cards for £5 per annum, a bus company spokesman said. The cards apparently carry an electronic chip inside, which is read by a scanner on the bus and will also provide statistics on passenger numbers. The passes have been put on hold and we are awaiting a new decision from the administration, the spokesman added. If the cards are not brought into use, there will be a full refund for those who bought one. Minister for Environment Dr. John Cortes has reconvened the Climate Change Forum. The forum was formed in 2006 as a technical advisory group and saw its first meeting since 2008 yesterday. The role of the group is to discuss, advise and raise awareness of local climate change issues within Gibraltar. This is in keeping with the government's commitment to have an environmental filter for government projects and policies. The GST have published further questions that they plan to ask the government in February's Parliament session. Shadow Minister for Employment Mr. FITAM is set to ask 23 questions and will mainly concentrate on employment issues concerning the future job strategy, the guaranteed superannuation fund, and the policy of the government towards the GDC and former GDC employees appointed to the civil service. In relation to the future job strategy, Mr. FITAM will be questioning Mr. Bossano on how many companies have signed the new scheme agreement to refund the expenses incurred by the Employment Training Company Limited if they do not hire the trainee. He will also probe the government as to whether it is supportive of the attempts by GSLP activists to form a new union in Gibraltar. And finally, head of radio, television presenter and newsreader Gerard Theuma has been appointed GBC's chief executive officer, Alan King's understudy. Mr. Theuma has worked for GBC since the 1980s and will take over as CEO next year. It is expected that Mr. Theuma will lead the changes of operations and infrastructure that were envisaged in the well-published King report. The plans to push GBC into a well-resourced, staffed and equipped modern broadcasting station are expected to be implemented over a course of 3 years. That's the YGTV News. I'm back on Monday. Have a great weekend.